Now, the question today is, can vitamin deficiencies actually cause serious disease? Now, you wouldn't ever connect a vitamin deficiency with a serious disease, but there are quite a few diseases that stem from nutrient deficiencies. Now, they're called classical deficiencies. So you have the classical scurvy, which is a vitamin C deficiency, rickets, vitamin D deficiency, osteomalacia, which is also a vitamin D deficiency, which most of the time occurs when you get a little bit older, Beri Beri, which is a B1 deficiency, pellagra, which is a vitamin B3 deficiency. So those are the classical deficiencies that are you'll see in many, many different textbooks. You also have subclinical deficiencies, which don't really show up physically yet. They're brewing in the oven, and eventually they create problems down the road. And you may notice some symptoms, but it's hard to recognize unless you understand the link between nutrient deficiencies and their manifestation. Now, a lot of these deficiencies start in the fetus, especially if you're not breastfed and you're consuming infant formula. There's some really, really important nutrients that a pregnant woman and someone who is breastfeeding must get in the diet. Enough zinc, vitamin D, folate, iodine, omega-3 fatty acids. These are vital. If you're deficient in iodine, first of all, you're going to have a stunted growth. Secondly, you're going to have a lower intelligence, so it can create a lot of issues. And so if your mother is deficient in folate, you can end up with what's called a neural tube defect, which means part of your spinal column is not closing properly. So your spinal cord is literally being exposed, and it's not protected. And vitamin D is really important in maintaining the structure of your skeletal system, as well as the tone of the muscles. So if you're deficient in vitamin D, you could have things like scoliosis, flat feet, kyphosis, which is hunchback, lordosis, which is an excessive low back curve, as well as a lot of dental problems in your maxillary bone and in your jaw. And it's interesting because if you look up information on classical deficiencies, they'll tell you that they're rare because of the fortification of foods where we added synthetic vitamins. But let's go down the list and talk about each one. A vitamin C deficiency, severe, scurvy, fatigue, bleeding gums, that's gingivitis, loss of connective tissue, rickets, that is low vitamin D, your legs start bowing out, your bones start to malform, like I already mentioned, you have a lot of muscle weakness and cramps. Then we get to beriberi, which is a vitamin B1 deficiency. Now, a severe B1 deficiency can create some serious disease, dementia, loss of memory, neuropathy, nerve damage. You get brain atrophy. Your brain actually shrinks when you don't have a certain nutrient. All these vitamins are cofactors. They're helper compounds to allow the chemistry in your body to work right. And so if you're missing one of these cofactors, it has profound effects down the road. Osteomalacia, that's basically soft bones. This happens mainly when you get older, but it also could occur when you're young as well. With this, there's pain in the legs. You have weakness in the muscles. You have weakness in the lower back. So how many people have low back pain and they don't realize it could be a subclinical osteomalacia or a vitamin D deficiency? Pellagra, they call it the four Ds. It's a B3 deficiency. Diarrhea, dermatitis, dementia, and death. And then we have night blindness, vitamin A. Vitamin A is very, very important. If you don't have enough, you could literally go blind. Then you have heart attacks. If you have a severe vitamin E deficiency, your heart can go into a cramp. It can cause angina, and you can have a heart attack. Now, a couple things I want to mention that are a little more interesting than what I just talked about. Number one, a lot of these deficiencies occur when you consume refined foods, okay? Because especially vitamin E, B3, B1, vitamin C, and even a vitamin D deficiency could be created when you're consuming refined foods. Consuming refined foods, as in refined carbohydrates, then lead to insulin resistance, and your ability to absorb these nutrients goes way down. But this is what I really want to talk about. These are the causes of these effects. These are the symptoms. These are the causes, right? But when you look up a lot of these symptoms, they're classified as a disease or a cause of something. And when you're researching a lot of things like bleeding gums, as in gingivitis, if you look to the cause of that, you don't even see vitamin C on the list. It's not even there. And so they say, well, it's a condition. It leads to excessive bleeding and you should brush your teeth more or dental floss your teeth, but they don't get into the nutritional causative factors. Let's say, for example, you looked up dementia. It doesn't even mention B1 at all, or even neuropathy. It doesn't even talk about B1. Or let's take dermatitis. Vitamin B3 is not even on the radar. And even when we get to heart attacks, which, by the way, this should be on the other side of this as being the symptom of low vitamin E. Look up heart attacks, they'll talk about, you know, smoking, not enough exercise, eating fatty foods, et cetera, et cetera. But what about this vitamin E? So there's a big disconnect between the nutrient deficiency effects to all of their symptoms, which then are classified as a disease. And it's very confusing. And, you know, when you treat symptoms and you don't really know the true cause, you never really get rid of the problem. Now, if you have not seen my video on the most nutrient-dense foods that you can eat, I put that right here. Check it out. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.